So earlier in the day, we of course had the U.S. Secretary for Defense as well as the Israeli counterpart speak to each other. And the U.S. Secretary for Defense had made it very, very clear that they are in a position to help U.S. citizens, allies at all levels. So it was a clear sign off. There were readings there that there would be attacks by Iran. U.S. had given out strong warnings and messaging. Israel had been doing so. But Srinjoy, could you help us understand at this point, how is the country, how are countries right now positioned? How are countries divided at the, even at the time when this entire Middle East challenge is escalating? All right, I think Srinjoy is not there. Shreya, if you could very quickly take us through what seems to be a series of escalations that have happened over the last 1 week.
That's right, Sneha. There has been, a series of escalation right from when those pagers went off shook the world. And in fact, not just pagers, then there were walkie-talkies, there were solar panels, there were instruments, all sorts of electronic devices blasting away and causing casualties in the Hezbollah group. Clearly reflected the fact that Israel was escalating this. But Israel, remember, has been calling all of these escalations as limited operations with no long-term occupation. In fact, today as well, when it launched its ground offensive, when it said that it is going to be, there is a ground invasion that's happening in southern Lebanon under Operation Northern Arrows. It said that it is a limited operation with precision strikes. But we know, Sneha, that in the past as well, when Israel carried out this limited operation in Rafah, it left the city in ruins, whether it was Gaza, overall Gaza Strip or Rafah, it did leave the city and its people in ruins. And therefore, a lot of questions were raised as well as to what this limited operation really means, what it is defined as, and how do you define long-term when you say there is no long-term occupation. Israel continuously reiterating the fact that this is about their survival, while Hezbollah, Hamas, the Houthis, the Palestinian Authority, all of them saying that Israel has gotten this upon itself, that it has been escalating the war, whether it was targeting the Hezbollah members, the Hamas top leadership, remember, last month we saw also being eliminated by Israeli forces and intelligence. So really, this has been a series of escalations, as multiple attacks that we've seen from the side of Israel. But what was being speculated and what was being feared was the how Iran will respond to this and whether Iran will actually get into it directly. Now we know that it has gotten into this entire conflict directly, leading to a much, much wider West Asian conflict, West Asian chaos, which will have wider implications,
That's
not
right.
just in West Asia, but across the world. Sneha.
That's right. In fact, Shreya, while Israel has gone on to say that there are these life-saving instructions that have been given across the country and that people have been sent to bunkers to protect themselves from the bombing that's been witnessed at this point, even as missiles have been launched by Iran. It's important to put in perspective the Revolutionary Guards that have described the missile attack as a retaliation for the assassination of not only the Hezbollah leader, Hassan Nasrallah, but also the Hamas leader, Ismail Haniyeh. So this, as we have been saying, this was in the offering. This was something that all the political experts were expecting. In fact, countries were talking to each other about this as well. US and Israel spoke earlier in the day to counter this threat as it is. But Iran really looking at it, not just from the perspective of the latest attack of Hassan Nasrallah, but also the earlier Hamas leader.
That's right, Sneha. And, political and military observers, geopolitical experts around the world have always maintained that Israel fights the three H's, which is Hamas, Hezbollah and the Houthis. And Israel has been maintaining that it is a fight for our survival, and therefore we will do everything in our strength, in our capabilities to eliminate Hamas, Hezbollah and the Houthis. And they have been doing that with the kind of escalations that we have seen. But with Iran now saying that it is not just Hassan Nasrallah, but the killing of Haniyeh as well as Roshan in the past clearly reflects the fact that, you know, they're not speaking only for Hezbollah, which is considered as Iran's proxy, but also for the Hamas and Houthi groups, the two other groups which have been fighting the war against Israel as well. So this clearly, you know, sort of reflects and defines the contours of what West Asia and how the Israel-Palestine conflict has been going on in the past. It's not just, you know, restricted to Israel and Palestine. It has now become wider. Iran is now a key player. We'll, of course, have to see United States, how it's going to react. Remember, United States has been maintaining that Israel has a right to defend itself, but it has also urged Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to practice restraint, something that Prime Minister Netanyahu has defied in all of these weeks. Today as well, when Israel launched the ground offensive. In fact, Prime Minister Netanyahu has not just defied the US statement, they've also, you know, Israel has also defied calls by world leaders, by the United Nations, world bodies to practice restraint. So that clearly is not happening. Israel, you know, completely reiterating the fact again and again that we will not stop until we eliminate every Hamas, Houthi and Hezbollah member. But how far this will continue, we'll have to wait and watch, because right now the Hezbollah top leadership is completely eliminated. They are looking for a replacement. When that happens, we will have to see how they respond. But for now, Iran officially responding on their behalf. Sneha.
Right, Shreya, very quickly, I think we have Shrinjoy back with us. Shrinjoy, while this escalation has happened, this of course is not just about two countries, or it's not just about Middle East, Shrinjoy. The world is so connected, particularly in the Middle East, with the trade, with so many countries dependent on this Middle East region. This is going to be a huge challenge globally.